Elspeth Knight Errant. Make sure to hit that follow button, friend. Welcome to the BSMG. Welcome to the show. Do we want to take the spell queller? You take the spell queller, right? No, he's got double witness. You take witness. Well, if you take queller, then he's playing on his own turn. If I don't take it, he's playing on ours. I guess it's still correct to take a witness, because if I just take queller, he'll just play witness, get back the queller. If I'm taking one of these witnesses, at least he's doing a little less recursion. I think for that reason I'm supposed to take a witness, and then we just play through the queller, and it's fine. Let's take the witness, and say go. His deck looks like a collector company deck to me. Like all these 2 and 3 drops. I would put him on collector company. Geist, oof. Night. Okay. Oh, well, just drew a verdict. Okay. It's not terrible. I mean, we know his hand is a witness and a spell crawler and a path. Because he's been playing everything he's top decked. Can we get into a position where we can set up this verdict better, or is this just our best spot for it? Take his other witness before trying to verdict? Well, he could actually take the verdict on the queller. We need to be aware of that. Because queller doesn't say anything about countering a spell, you're exiling a spell off the stack. It goes away. If we remove the queller, then the verdict will go off, but something to think about. Just from the perspective of tempo. But yeah, we could take it. We could take the other witness. We're playing for the long game, that's definitely what we do. Another play could just be to de-sphere the knight, just to kind of slow his roll. You know, let's just thought the witness, and you know what he might even do? He might spell quell the ancestral. It might be what he's trying to do, you know? That would really suck. I mean, we're about to get this value off, you know? Maybe I was supposed to just wrath the board. If I don't take the queller, sure, he can next turn just go witness, get back queller, but if I don't take queller, he's going to quell the ancestral, right? So that's worth thinking about. How bad do I want this ancestral to be successful? Because if you quell that and then it, you know, he quells the vision, though, verdict's going to draw us 3. All right, let's just stick with the original plan. Sticking with the original plan. Go. That's true, it just says cast without paying mana cost. We wouldn't have to, like, resuspend it. It's not like it's, like a remand. Thinking this is going to be a hollowed fountain. Yeah, it's going to be a hollowed fountain. I tried to make the deck more in the white, blue-white vein, and then the black is the splash. So we should never need, we shouldn't really ever need double black mana. He doesn't attack. That's cool. Oh, we milled the fudge. I can still get white-white. Oh boy. Maybe we should add a second fountain. Maybe. So it looks like he really wants to quell this Ancestral. So he quells the Ancestral, we swing of the Spirits, Wrath aboard. Here comes the Queller. To quell my vision. It's fine. Well, our attack isn't even great. He'll just chump block a Spirit. But if we're just wrathing the board, it doesn't matter. Got him. Well, watch him have like some sort of absurd card we're not even thinking about for the Knight to search up. It's very possible. Yes, I'd like to draw three. Yeah, he didn't even block, did he? That's peculiar. We know that this is just getting a path, right? This Thoughtseize is probably just getting a path. Oh, he has another Spellcrawler. Okay. We'll path it, get back our Thoughtseize. Thoughtseize his path. Then souls. I don't even know if we really needed to do that. Give me that path. Give me it. Give it to me. Alright, let's actually flash back the souls we already had. I'm excited about it. It's obviously not where it needs to be yet, team, but it's alright, Knight. But it could have been an instant speed Thoughtseize, says Shade. Oh no, you're right. I could have waited. No, you're totally right. If I'd waited, we could have seized the Knight. Opportunity missed, man. It was a missed opportunity. Why don't we just use the... I mean, he could have like a walker or something. That'd be a reason to keep the D-Sphere over just pathing this. Scour him. But if we scour ourselves, there's potential to hit more souls. Speaking of more souls, I can cast and recast this soul. Which is relevant because he's at 12. So let's put 6 power on the table. This is going to hurt, though. It's worth it. Souls, souls. Oops, need black mana. Go. 2-turn clock. Yeah, I mean, sometimes you gotta take that pain. I think this game was pretty much about the, this game really was about the wrath, this game. The verdict was, see Nightfall running Elspeth. All right, so we're 2-0. Let's keep it going. Let's keep it going. Yeah, it's nice to see some new faces tonight. And I see some of you guys have Twitch Prime. Been trying to figure out how to do it. I'm sure it's very simple. I just haven't actually done it. I'm sure it's very simple to link up. I actually do have Prime, Amazon Prime, so it's just you have to link it, right? How I like the collective brutality. Actually, we were running more in the original Esper build we were messing around with, Shame Spiral. I like it, it's because of its flexibility. I think there are a lot of instances of sorceries that are relevant in Modern. I think in the same vein where I was talking about how I liked in the Brandon Ajar at Jeskai that we lovingly called Bird Brain. I had a different name for it, but everybody ended up calling the deck Bird Brain. But that was running the Transmute spell that counters instances of sorceries, and it was actually really good. There's a lot of instances and sorceries in Modern that are relevant, countering everything from other counter spells to removal spells to certain combo spells. Like a lot of combo, like you know, Scape Shift, your Ad Nauseams, Pass in Flames. What's up, Foil Johnny? You've missed lurking in my streams. What's up, Daddy? Oh man, it's hard living, working over full time actually. I've had an interesting few weeks, I'll tell you that much. It's been interesting. Yeah. We can talk about it later, I'd rather focus on Magic. Cause we have some new faces tonight on the Bruce Spy Show. I was kind of disappointed to see that the card hoarder tournaments that we were trying to plan, some of them just didn't happen. And not enough people signed up, basically. Anyway. Your friends can see who you're watching, Adamaniac. People that you friended on Twitch, they can see. They added that feature recently. They can see who you're watching. Which I think is kind of cool. Promotes social interaction on Twitch. You know, you don't necessarily go there to watch the person who's streaming, you might go there to chat with your buddy. Hard living? Yeah. This is kind of just a smattering of spells though, because I really couldn't make up my freaking mind tonight when I was brewing, so... It's a bit of a smattering. I'm gonna use that word liberally here. Alright, good luck and have fun. This is a smattering of spells. Oh yeah, Gear Hulk. The green, white, and blue Gear Hulks seem awesome. Green, at least for standard. Blue has some potential to be played elsewhere, maybe even white. I just like the idea of flashing in a Gear Hulk and then from there doing some pretty nutty stuff. So you're gonna get to see the modes on Brutality be kinda cool in a moment here. So we're gonna have the Spell Snare ready to go for his Eidolon, because that would be brutal.